हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 4 ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 2 ऑफ कंप्यूटर एंड नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी सब्जेक्ट। माई सेल्फ निकुल जायसवाल, लेक्चरर इन कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग, श्री केजे पॉलिटेक्निक, भरूच। सो यूनिट नंबर 2 इज ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल सिक्योरिटी। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड द पासवर्ड सिलेक्शन एंड टॉपिक नंबर 2, पीपल एज अ सिक्योरिटी टूल। Now, in this lecture, we will discuss the third major topic of unit number 2, that is physical security. And in physical security, we have two topics. First is access control and second is biometrics. So in today's lecture, we will discuss the access control, and in the next lecture, we will discuss biometrics. So first of all, let's have a quick recap of our previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we have discussed the security awareness. So many of the users do not aware of the securities related to computers and information. So most of the organization provides the security awareness program. So in that training, all the information related to securing their computers or securing their information will be provided. And after that, we have discussed the individual user responsibility. So every user of the organization have some responsibilities toward their organization related to security of their information. So every user have some responsibilities that we have already discussed in previous lecture. Now in today's lecture, we will discuss the access control, and after that we will discuss categories of access control, and we will also discuss the types of access control and where we use this and the type of access controls. So from access control, you can imagine the definition of the access control, that the procedure to provide the access to certain users will be called as a access control. That means which type of information or which type of resources can be used by or can be accessed by which type of user will be defined by the access control mechanism. So normally access control mechanism provide the authentication and authorization. Authentication means it will identify the authentic user, and it will differentiate authentic user and unauthentic users, and it will also provide the authorization, that means access to the information to authorized person only. So normally the access control will provide the authentication and authorization. So access control is a security technique that regulates who can view or use resources or information in computing environment. So this is the technique or the procedure that will be used to define which type of information or resources will be used by which user in computing environment. So access control system performs identification, authentication, that we have already discussed, that it will provide the authentication and authorization of users and entities by evaluating required login credentials that can include passwords, then PIN numbers and biometric scans. So access control will provide the authentication and authorization by using several techniques like user ID, password, then PIN numbers and biometric scans. Most of the large organization have biometric techniques to perform the authentication and authorization. The goal of access control is to minimize the risk of unauthorized access to physical and logical system. So the major goal of the access control is to minimize the risk of unauthorized access. That means no unauthorized user should access the confidential information that has been stored in computer or in organization. That is the major goal of access control. So access control is process that is integrated into an organization's IT environment. So every organization's IT environment will have the mechanism of access control. Access control systems are complex and can be challenging to manage in dynamic IT environment. So what is dynamic IT environment? When the IT environment changes periodically, in that type of environment, or the files that has been stored in systems are changing periodically, in this type of environment, the access control system will be complex to manage. So we have two categories of access control. First is physical access control, and second is logical access control. So physical access control will provide the authentication and authorization toward the physical resources, and like buildings and rooms. and physical resources of organization, and logical access control will provide the authentication and authorization towards the logical entities, that means the files and records that has been stored in computer systems. So physical access control limits the access to computers, buildings, rooms, and physical IT assets. So for the physical devices, the access control that has been used will be called as a physical access control mechanism. And logical access control mechanism limits connection to computer networks, system files, and data. So normally logical access control will be provided by the software or the operating systems, and for the physical access control we use different type of mechanisms like biometrics. So we have major four type of access control system. First is mandatory access control, it is also called as a MAC. So it is the strictest type of access control in IT environment. Next is discretionary access control. So normally all the operating system provides access control of discretionary access control. Then next is role-based access control. It is also called as a non-discretionary access control. And the last is rule-based access control. So we have major four categories of access control. First is mandatory access control, second is discretionary access control, third is role-based access control, it is also called as a non-discretionary access control, and last is rule-based access control. Now let's discuss all the access control mechanism in detail. So the first is mandatory access control. So this is the strictest form of access control mechanism that has been used in organization. So normally all the government agencies and military services will use this type of access control, and this it is also very complex access control system, and it is very hard to manage mandatory access control system. So strictest of all level of access controls use hierarchical approach to controlling the access to resources, that we will see in next couple of minutes what is the hierarchical approach to controlling the access to resources. Then used in government and military environments, so all the government agencies and military environments environment contains the confidential information about government and military. So to provide the access control mechanism in this type of environment, they use the mandatory access control system. So access to all resource objects is controlled by setting defined by system administrator. So this is also called as a centrally managed access control system. So in this access control system, all the resource objects, that means physical object or logical object, all the resource objects, the access to that resource objects will be controlled by the system administrator, that will be basically based on the operating system mechanisms. The resource object and user accounts are assigned security labels. So all the objects, resource objects, whether it is a logical resource object or whether it is a physical resource object, all the resource object will assign the security labels. That means the security labels contain two types of information. First is classification and second is category. So classification may be, if we talk about the information, then the classification of the information will be top secret, secret, confidential. So these are the three major type of classification of the information. So top secret information, then secret information, and confidential information. So all the objects, resource objects, and user account will have a security labels, and the security labels will contain the classification and category. So all the resource object will have a classification and category, and all the user account will have a classification and category. Now how the access will be provided? Now let's suppose any user tries to access some information from the computer system. Now what the operating system will do, it will check the security label of resource object. That means if a user want to access some file, the operating system will check the security labels of file and the security labels of user. If the both security labels of files and user compares, it will compare the security labels of files and user, and if it is if the comparison is we can say that if the comparison is positive, if the comparison is positive, then the access to that file will be provided to that user. And if the comparison is negative, then the access to that file for the user will not be provided. This is how the mandatory access control mechanism works. So all the files will have security labels, classifications and category, and all the users will also have the security labels. Then if any user want to access some file, the operating system or the access control mechanism will check the label of file and the user, and it will compare the labels of a file and user, and the comparison, if the comparison is positive, then the access to that file will be given to that user, and if the comparison is negative, then access to that file for the user will not be given. So it is very complex system, and the major disadvantage of this mandatory access control is, before implementing access control mechanism, you need to configure all these settings in the operating system. Then and then you can use the mandatory access control mechanism. So before implementing mandatory access control, all the labeling of files and user must be done before using the mandatory access control mechanism. So when user attempt to access a resource, the system checks with user security level and compare to the properties of object security level. So what the system will do, it will check the label of user and it will check the label of objects, resource object. So MAC requires high amount of planning before implementation and also imposes a high system management overhead. So this is the major disadvantage of mandatory access control, that require the high amount of planning before implementation. Clear? And so this was all about the mandatory access control. Now next is discretionary access control. So all the latest operating system will come with the DAC, that is discretionary access control. So allow each user to control access to their own data. Now that means if I am the owner of some data, then I will decide which user will access this data or the file. So access control will be defined by the owner of the user. So all the major operating system, desktop operating system, comes with the discretionary access control, and Windows also uses this type of access control mechanism. So default access control mechanism for most desktop operating system. So instead of security labels, in the case of Mac, DAC has an access control list associated with each resource object. So each and every file in the operating system will have an access control list. So all the Windows, in the Windows operating system, all the file will have an access control list. So access control list will contain the name of the user who is allowed to use this file or access this file. It can also provide the information about what operation can be performed by the user. If the user can modify the file, if the user can read the file, or if the user can write the file also. So operations and the list of user who can access that file will be given in access control list. So an ACL contains list of users or groups to which the owner user has permitted access to resource object with level of access. So level of access will be a read, write and full control. So user A provides read only access on one of his file to user B and read and write access on same file to user C. So the owner of the user will decide which user will get access to their files and which type of operations they can perform on that file. So more flexible environment than mandatory access control. So this is the example of Windows access control list. So this is the example of my computer and one of the file that has been stored in my computer. So in the left side, you can see in the uppermost portion, it is written object name. That means the name of the file, resource file. Resource object, it is also called as a resource object. So this is the name of the file and where it is stored. and below that, that is group or usernames. That means group and username that are allowed to access that file. Now first group is authenticated user. Now I have clicked on the authenticated user, and the permission that has been given to that authenticated user are, they can modify is allowed. You can see in below, modify is allowed, read and execute is allowed, read allowed, and write is also allowed. So these are the operation that can be performed by the users that has been put in authenticated user. Now if you click on advanced, you can add the user also. So by clicking the advanced, you will the next control panel will be open. So you can see in the right figure. So from the below, you can see the add. So you can add the user to give the access. So you can also modify the access, and you can also add the user for the access. So Windows operating system uses the access control list for providing the access to information, that is also called as a discretionary access control. Now next is role-based access control. It is also called as a non-discretionary access control. So also known as a non-discretionary access control, based on user's job function within the organization. So this is based on the object-oriented mechanisms. So we use the user's job function in the organization to access the information. So it will assign permission to access resource object to particular roles in the organization. So based on the role, that means if in the organization, if any person works as an accountant, then the accountant will have access to all the files that has been allowed for the accountant. So all the access to the information will be given to the role based. So users are then assigned to that particular roles. An accountant in a company will be assigned to the accountant role. So it will permit access to all the resources permitted to all accountant. Similarly, a software engineer might be assigned to a developer role. So developer role, all the users in the developer role can access all the information that has been assigned to a software engineers. So users may have multiple roles also. So in the manager of the organization can see the files related to account also, and can see the files related to HR also. So many of the user can have a multiple roles also in the role-based access control mechanism. Next and the last is rule-based access control mechanism. So as from the name, you can guess that access control mechanism will be based on the certain rules. So access is allowed or denied to resource object based on set of rules defined by system administrator. Access properties are stored in access control list associated with each resource object. So all the resources object will have a access control list. When user attempt to access a resource, operating system check the rules contained in the ACL. So when any user request for the information or try to access the file, what the operating system will do is it will check the rules associated in ACL. So these rules are based on conditions such as days of the week, time of the day, or location. That means how many days the user can access the information, then which time in a day the user can access that information, and from which location user can access this information. So this type of access control rules mechanism will be called as a rule-based access control mechanism. So in this rule-based access control mechanism, we will have certain rules defined by the system administrator to perform the access control. Normally we use the role-based access control and rule-based access control mechanism together in many organizations. So it is most common scenario that most of the organization uses role-based and rule-based access control mechanism to enforce the access policies and procedures. So this was all about the access control mechanism. I hope you did understand all the topics that has been discussed in this video lecture. Thank you so much.